Well, everybody, it's here. Madden 22 has arrived, and to kick off Madden season, it's time to unveil this year's franchise team, the Philadelphia Eagles. Excited to see where this series is going to take us, and excited to get this series underway. We'll be spending a lot of time in Lincoln Financial Field with the Eagles in 2021 and beyond. Kicking off a brand new rebuild with different questions that need to be answered and a different path than what we had with the Buccaneers back in Madden 20. And we'll see just how long it takes for the Eagles to reach that same championship dynasty level plateau that we were able to reach with the Buccaneers very quickly. But how quickly the mighty fall 2018 was only 3 years ago. And since that Super Bowl victory, the Eagles have not been the same team, but we're gonna try to get them back to that level very quickly. And we'll be doing that with former Illinois Tech linebacker, national champion, All-American, and now Eagles head coach, Ricky Hodges. Love to see it. Hodges went undrafted following his senior season, ended up getting an assistant coaching job with the Eagles, and eventually climbed the ranks to head coach. So those of you that enjoyed the Buccaneers franchise, good news, this is pretty much version 2.0 of that, just a different team, and doing it with a coach instead of an owner, which does have its differences. Some of them I like, some of them I don't. With the coach, you get the more personal player to coach interactions, but as an owner, you have to manage the funds and you just don't have an unlimited signing bonus pool to pull from as you do with the coach. So we'll try not to get too out of control with those. Just going through some of the settings before we head into the new franchise hub. I kind of like the old one. It was definitely faster than this one, even on next gen, which is kind of interesting. But there's a lot of new stuff to go through, including the new staff management. So head coach is Ricky Hodges. Kicking off the series, I will be sticking with the Eagles' default playbook and their scheme. We'll make adjustments heading into year two. Our offensive coordinator is Joseph Wells, and DC is Bill Summers. Win or lose, who knows how long these guys will be here. Probably not too long. Taking a look at the head coach talent tree under player growth, we already have Secret Remedy unlocked, which decreases multi-week injury recovery time. That is good news. Under that, you have offense and defense specific trees, so you have increased XP for linemen, receivers, safeties, DBs, corners. Goes without saying, but with Hodges being a linebacker in college and a defensive-minded coach, we will be going with the defensive skill tree. Below that, it comes together under final piece, which gives all players scheme fit during training. Fountain of Youth will slow the regression for one position group per season. And then under We've Seen Enough, it reveals a hidden depth trait for one player once per season. Under staff modifications, first unlock here, Eye for Talent, lowers the talent cost for player personnel by 10%. More offensive and defensive coordinator abilities on either side. One lowers the cost of talent points. You have a talent point refund when replacing a coordinator, which is nice. Then you also have an increased hiring bonus when signing an OC or DC, which is also kind of nice. Coming together under after-school tutoring, which gives you up to 3 additional focus players, so 6 focus players per season. That's kind of insane. And then mistakes were made, which gives you the chance to reset a talent tree for your OC, DC, or player personnel. Our offensive coordinator already coming in with pliability, which boosts the injury rating for all offensive players by 4. Also comes in with brace for impact, which gives us a +1 to catch in traffic for all tight ends. Actually, now that I think about it, I haven't mentioned this, and I'm sure you've heard this from other content creators. I will not be officially starting the series until the scouting update drops in September, because when that scouting update drops, you have to start a brand new franchise. That patch does not apply to already existing franchises, regardless of it being an offline or cloud save. So if you didn't know that, now you know. So with these talents for the OCs and DCs kind of rolling randomly, we may or may not have the same talent starting out again. Onto player personnel, this is where things get kind of interesting. Mentors wanted a 5% trade discount for 30-year-old players. You can lower the value of CPU draft picks. You can increase your draft pick value up to 4%. Online one guarantees a trade package. This next one, quite the sales pitch, will give non-X-Factor user players a 1 dev trait higher value in trades. So star players getting superstar value, superstar getting X Factor. That's insane. You can also increase and decrease the value of CPU and user players. I'll be spending a lot of points in player personnel. 5% discount on players under 80 overall. You can get that up to 90, I believe. There's a set of branches you could take here. You can get a free agency boost for safeties. You can get a free agency boost for offensive linemen. And you can get a free agency boost for defensive linemen. But then you think about the path you'd have to take for the safeties. That locks you into a scheme fit bonus. You get a fullback and halfback bonus under offensive linemen and a linebacker bonus under the defensive linemen. Again, Hodges being a defensive coach, we may have to go that direction. But under that, branching from the middle and right tree, you get a bonus for wide receivers. And branching from the left and middle tree, you get a bonus for corners. So do you go secondary initially or do you go with defensive line? Quarterback bonus is one of the final ones, and you also get a not interested in a lock for renegotiations, very similar to NCAA 14. This Eagles roster is an interesting one because our best players are either already regressing, about to enter regression, or on the verge of retirement. And with a majority of this roster needing to be re-signed next year, as we'll see when we go through contracts in a minute, this is going to be a very interesting first couple of years for this series. But kicking things off, Devontae Smith, rookie receiver, Alabama Heisman winner. Face scan, not in the game quite yet. Don't complain. They obviously can't get everybody. But I'm very excited. Devontae Smith has potential, but can he be our number one receiver down the line? Can he produce? Easy to say in a series where you're using, yeah, I could get him the football, but in this kind of series, who knows? Quarterback, also one of the big questions for the Eagles. Jalen Hurts entering year two, 71 overall. I like Jalen Hurts. I think Hurts could develop, but Deshaun Watson is on the trade block, and we've got three first-round picks we could burn. Hurts only has 84 throw power, not elite. Accuracies are okay. He's got mobility, but is Jalen Hurts the guy that you want to bet your franchise on? Last year, when he played, 1,000 yards, 6 touchdowns, 4 picks, 52%. Not quite the elite year, but we'll see what he can do in year 2. Behind Hurts is Joe Flacco, 36 years old on a 1-year deal. Better throw power, accuracies around the same. Hopefully, Hurts plays well because I would hate to have to bench him and put in Joe Flacco. Regardless, I think we're looking for a quarterback this upcoming offseason. Moving on to running backs. Kerryon Johnson, as I'm recording this video, actually got hurt and released. It's unfortunate, but the running back core is not too shabby here in Philly. The receiving core could use some work. Devontae Smith, by far, is the best receiver on this roster. Travis Fulham, not a bad number two. Greg Ward's a quarterback turned receiver. Jalen Reagor looking for some better production in year two. We'll see if he can develop. Arcega Whiteside's kind of a project, maybe a release. And John Hightower, Boise State product. Let's get him the football. On to tight ends. Dallas Goedert really emerging as a number one option. Zach Gertz regressing down to an 80, but still a pretty good starting two. Our offensive line starting out is pretty good, but not so much on the left side. Jordan Mailata, or Mailata, let me know how that's pronounced. 85 strength, 71 pass block, and 72 run, could be better. Definitely going to see a position battle at left guard. Veteran Isaac Sumalo, 84 strength, 70 pass block, and 72 run. He will probably lose his job to rookie Landon Dickerson out of Alabama, coming in 92 strength, 67 pass block, 71 run, ratings around the same. Dickerson's younger, can develop, probably leaning that way regardless of what happens. The rest of our O-line, elite. Jason Kelce, 91 overall, but as I said earlier, 33 years old, that 85 strength will dip. The pass block at 84 will dip. The run block at 98 is elite, but that will also dip. Brandon Brooks is 32. 95 strength for him, so he'll still be good for quite some time. 92 pass block and 91 run. We'll see just how aggressive the regression is with our offensive linemen. And then at right tackle, Lane Johnson, 88 overall, 31 years old. Big time contract for him as well. He just got a new one. It's expensive. Age also an issue for the defense, but we have some solid veterans that may help us make a playoff push. I don't know about this first year. We'll see how things go. Graham is 33. Kerrigan is 33. 85 overall and 74. We have a pretty solid rotation on the front line. Derek Barnett, 76. Overall, he's 25 years old. Good pass rusher with that 79 power move and 74 block shed. Should be able to hold his own. Josh Sweat, also pretty solid player. Same overall, a little bit younger. Back to Fletcher Cox, the only X factor on the team, 30 years old, dominant pass rusher with that 95 power move, also pretty good against the run with 85 block shed. Javon Hargrave is the number two. We do play a 4-3, and I'll probably keep it that way as opposed to going to a 3-4 again. Off-ball linebacker will be a project. Jannard Avery is 68 overall, 85 speed, zone coverage is practically non-existent for him. There'll be an early replacement, final year under contract for him. Eric Wilson, 76 overall, also with 85 speed, 26 years old. Decent player, you know, not too bad, 66 zone, good play recognition. Zone and man coverage, not the worst. Other linebacker is Alex Singleton, also final year under contract for him. 85 speed for all our starting linebackers right now. He's got 62 zone coverage. Block shedding could be better, but we'll see what these guys can do. This secondary is going to be an interesting one for the first couple of years of the series. Darius Slay, former Lion, still a very good player. Superstar dev, good speed, 91 zone, 87 man. Of course, already regressing, so who knows how long he'll be at this level, but two pretty good abilities starting out. Deep route KO gives him increased knockout chance and man-to-man against passes 20 yards down the field. Also has Acrobat, which gives him increased range for pass breakups and interceptions. So kind of exciting. We'll see if he can make some plays any better. This contract is ridiculous. Making $6 million this year, 2022 and 2023. 2022 making $22 million and 2023 making $23 million. Someone's playing a cruel joke on me right now. That's ridiculous. Number two corner wearing number three is Steven Nelson. Decent speed, good man coverage, also pretty solid press. And then Avante Maddox is our number three. Not sure who's playing in the slot. It more than likely will be Maddox, but you never know. Depends on who plays that position the best. More age concerns, and now kind of getting into some speed concerns. Anthony Harris has 86 speed, zone coverage and 82. That could be okay, but our starting strong safety is Rodney McLeod, and I'm not entirely sure if I want to trust our default playbook to have these guys playing man-to-man coverage against receivers. It's going to be a very long day if that happens. Kicking situation could be worse. Jake Elliott, 97 power, 78 accuracy, not too bad. Awareness rating also should be able to let him nail kicks consistently in the sim, I would hope. Definitely not an Evan Moore. And you guys know how punters can be when you don't have very good accuracy ratings. Aaron Sipos, or however you pronounce the name. 91 power is good, but 69 accuracy is not. We'll see if we can work on that. So what does the future have in store when it comes to money? Currently with almost $60 million in cap room, but the numbers next year likely much smaller. A lot of players are on one-year deals here in Philly. That's how you build a roster when your back's against the wall when it comes to cap room like the Eagles were this past offseason. And with the Darius Slay contract coming up, I don't know necessarily how we're going to handle this next year. And then the year after that, Fletcher Cox, Brandon Graham, Miles Sanders, a lot of our other rotational players, and then 3 years from now, Jalen Hurts part of this group, Jalen Reagor. And another issue is we're not going to see any cap relief until maybe 2023, 2024. And that's dependent on how much money I feel like spending in free agency trying to make this team better. 2022, next season, top contracts, Fletcher Cox, Darius Slay, Brandon Brooks, Hargrave, 2023, Slay, Brooks, Johnson, Devontae Smith. So 2023 is really our first year off. And then the year after that, Brandon Brooks, top salary. Devontae Smith is our third best. Jake Elliott, the kicker. I guess we'll see how we handle contracts going forward. Again, this series not officially starting, but one thing to kind of keep an eye on is your top stories. The Chargers losing rookie left tackle Rashawn Slater for 2 weeks. due to an injury. This is not an IRL injury. This was not part of a roster update. This is something that happened because the Chargers did a full patch practice, which is one of the new features in franchise mode this year when it comes to your weekly training. So the upside is you get the most XP and you get the bigger boost for game plan focusing, but you also have a higher chance of injury and a lower fatigue recovery. You also have half pads, which gives you lower XP and gameplay boost, but lower injury chance and more fatigue recovery. Like I showed earlier, you can have 6 focus players per week for your game plan. We don't have that unlocked, nowhere close to it. Likely be an early focus of mine because that sounds awesome, but this will likely be the 3 focus players that I use when the series officially starts following the scouting update: Devontae Smith, Jalen Hurts, and Landon Dickerson. So many ways to go with those stat points, though. We'll see what happens. On to the schedule, we get things kicked off with the Falcons on the road, a 18-week, 17-game schedule. Still going to take a while to get used to, but a very interesting schedule. We have the Bucs, the Super Bowl champs. We have the Chargers and Justin Herbert. Our bye week is all the way in week 14. That is insane. And then a slew of division games to end the year. Washington, New York, Washington again. And then closing the year against the Dallas Cowboys. So what's our record going to be at the end of this season? 0-18 would be bad. But that, guys, will do it for me and this introduction episode for the Eagles Rebuild franchise. Super excited to get this underway. I know a lot of you enjoyed the Bucs, and I know that some of you didn't enjoy the Bucs, but do not worry. When that September update drops, I will be announcing franchise number 2. I can't do that one quite yet because that one requires a little extra work, which would require the patch to be in the game. So I'll keep you guys updated. Make sure you follow me on Twitter whenever that update drops. Pretty much within the next couple of days, we will officially have this series underway. Until then, I have some other plans. I have another video dropping either today or tomorrow. And just to fill the franchise void, I will be finishing the Bucs franchise. We'll get through this final season and then probably do a long-term sim. And also kind of a mini series for Madden 22. Little fun one. But thank you guys for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for waiting for me. Those of you that stuck around, I really appreciate it. We're back. Content's back. Football's back on the channel. Can't wait to get going. Catch you guys next time. Have a nice day.